It's amazing how
I'm Bob.
Hey, you got a brick with you.
Man, oh man.
We're doing a little
Brother, you don't know how good this is.
I've done a lot of work to it.
Hey, I'm with my buddy Bob Skaggs, and Bob lives in Sandy Hook, Kentucky. And Bob, this is a big day for you, isn't it?
A big day, probably the biggest day in my life.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are standing at the gravesite of Keith Whitley. And Bob is now getting Keith Whitley's car, the 1985 world famous Corvette, had some great owners, Dottie West, Keith Whitley, Lorrie Morgan. And Bob, it's now going to a place that you will keep it forever in pristine condition. Is that correct?
It will be in the Whitley family from now on.
That is wonderful.
It's wonderful to be here with you, and I appreciate y'all coming out. And this is a big day, and there's a, you know, Keith's music is probably, you know,
oh, it's unbelievable how famous he's become since he's passed away. Ladies and gentlemen, we are at the gravesite for one reason, and that was, this is where the last time you saw this car, parked it right here at the grave on the day that they buried Keith, is that right?
Yes.
We're proud that you're the one that's going to get it. Hey, I want to show you this. What's the deal on the $2?
There's a $2 bill club, and it is for special members only, and it's a good luck charm.
I got it. I'm never going to spend this one. I really appreciate you giving it to me. You were close to Keith, weren't you? What was he like growing up?
There was 5.5 years difference in Keith and my age.
Yeah.
And he was just, I mean, he was...
Was he singing and picking as a kid?
Oh, yeah. I mean...
Did you know something was going on with this guy that one day that it would he would be a major star? Yeah.
Some of my earliest memories is that I can remember standing in front of the TV at my grandmother's when he was on... My mom took him to the Buddy Starcher show.
Right.
And then I remember him in a talent contest. He had an electric guitar.
Right.
And he had... my grandmother had made him a Batman, you know, cape and hood. And he had three Robins behind him dancing. And he was doing the Batman and Robin theme of the old TV series.
Yeah.
With Adam West.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's just some of the early memories. And
so you knew from the beginning there was something special about Keith, huh?
Yeah. I mean, he didn't read music or anything, you know, at the time. And
just natural talent, wasn't it?
Yeah. I mean, he could listen to it and, you know.
Well, you know, when you are at a music venue or club, there's never a day goes by that someone's not playing a Keith Whitley song, you know? And it's just such an honor to meet you. I want to show this title. This is the title to the car. We never had it taken out of Lori's name. But Lorrie Morgan, her father was so famous, George Morgan. He had a big song called Candy Kisses. And I thought it was funny or interesting that the title to the car is Loretta L. Morgan, Loretta Lynn Morgan, of course. George Morgan, Loretta Lynn, super friends. And he named her after his beloved friend. And it's just wonderful to have you here.
And Keith and George were friends.
They were buds, huh?
Yeah, Keith met George early on down here before,
right,
you know, Lorrie ever came into the picture. And he was talking about, you know, George was such a nice fella, friendly and,
right,
you know, just, you know, common and, you know, made him feel welcome. And, you know, I guess this town can be...
It can be a little rough, yeah.
Yeah.
I tell you what, my dad, of course, Merle Kilgore, you know him as also a songwriter, but also as Hank Williams Jr.'s manager. And I remember Dad telling me, hey, I want you to come out and see this guy that's opening our show, Keith Whitley. And I said, well, you know, Dave Pomeroy, my brother-in-law, had played on Keith's song, playing the bass, and I saw him on a lot of videos. You can still see him on those videos. But when I saw him open for Hank Jr., I told my dad, I said, you know what? This guy is going to be a sensation because of the way the crowd loves him. And he's so sincere. You know, sometimes being phony on it never works. You know?
Let me tell you what, Keith felt every note
he did,
that he sang. I mean,
he
You know, he was there. He was transported to wherever that was at, and, you know.
Yeah.
And
Bob, I kind of feel that you're a spiritual man. And you know what? I know this may sound crazy, folks. We are at a cemetery. But I feel a Keith Whitley vibe. I feel like he's maybe here with us. There's a group of people here with us. And I just got that little feeling going. Hey, I just want to thank you and tell you that how proud we are that a member of the Whitley family is taking this piece of country music history, making sure it's safe and secure from days to come, you know. This car needs to go on for generations and generations and generations.
This car will only be brought out for special functions.
Wonderful.
The Keith Whitley ride is going to be June the 23rd, 24th, and 25th. They're going to be down here.
What month?
June.
June month. Tonight. Yeah. 2017. Okay.
Yes, sir. And the car will be here then. And then on July the 1st, which is Keith's birthday,
right?
They're having a get together in Sandy Hook. And the car's going to be up there on display.
May 19th, 1989. That's when.
May 9th, yes.
That's when Keith left us. Bob, it's been a pleasure meeting you, talking to you. And we're just so proud that you're the new owner of this. This is Steve Kilgore with the Nashville Music Guide saying so long.
I'm no stranger to the rain. I've been sacrificed by brothers, crucified by lover. Through it all, I've withstood the pain. I'm no stranger